Hello viewers, I'm Advocate Kia Rawat from Lexington Company. Today I'm going to talk about the concept of the summary sale. So, first we're going to talk about the institution of summary sale. In order to institute a suit under summary procedure, the nature of the suit must be among the following classes. Suit upon bill of exchange, hundis and promissory notes. Suits for recovering a debt or liquidated demand in money with or without interest arising on a written contract. Or on an enactment, the recoverable sum should be fixed in money, or it should be in the nature of debt than the other a penalty. Or only a guarantee. Here, claim should be in respect of a debt liquidated demand only. A summary suit is instituted by presenting the plaint in an appropriate civil court. Contents of plaint summary procedure are, apart from the facts above of the cause of action, the plaint must contain a specific affirmation that the suit is filed under the order. It should also contain that no such relief has been claimed which does not fall under the ambit of Rule 27 of the CPC. In the title of the suit, following inscription must be under therefore of the suit. Now, procedure after the institution of summary suit. Under summary procedure, the defendant has to get the leave to defend from the court. A burden is placed upon the defendant to disclose the facts sufficient to entitle him to defend in the application for leave to defend. So this is the gist of the summary suit. If you are clear with the concept, then it's okay. If not, then do let me know in the comment section so that I can clear up all your doubt regarding the summary procedure and the institution of summary suit. Till then, take care of yourself. I'll see you guys super soon in my next video with some other legal topics.